Dear students, welcome and thank you for tuning in to this video. This is the second video of problem number three. In the previous video, we started analyzing the truss that you can see to your left, and we were able to create a section. But before we created the section, we were able to find all the support reaction forces, and we found out that Ey here is equal to 20.2 kilonewtons, and we created a section on this side. And we said that, okay, we have the first triangle and we created three forces coming out of that section from J to G, and we call this FJG, and we call this force FJC, and these are the member forces, and we call this force FCD. So in the previous video, we were able to find the first equation of equilibrium, which is summation of moments around point J to be zero, and we had that thing covered. And now in this video, we're going to continue the work by analyzing summation of forces on the x-axis equal to zero and summation of forces on the y-axis equal to zero. And we said before doing this, we needed to be able to resolve FJG and FJC into x and y components. And also in the previous video, we have figured out that the angle here, theta, and we found that theta equals tan inverse. The opposite, which is 1 here, divided by the adjacent, which is 1.5, that's the length. And theta we figured out to be 34 degrees. And we have said that if we would like to analyze or resolve the forces, let me draw the x and y axes here. So that's the x-axis, this is the y-axis. We want to resolve FJC. So let me resolve FJC in green. I know that this is 34, right? From parallel analysis, we know that this is 34 degrees. So if I want to resolve FJC, what I will have is this first force. This is going to be FJC cosine 34. And going down here, I'm going to have FJC sine 34. This way I've resolved FJC, this force. Also, if you do the analysis for this angle, let me do it in a different color. So let me do magenta. If I want to resolve FJG, I need to be able to say what is the angle this point. So if you look, it's similar to what we did in the theta. So if you come here, this is your structure. So this is the theta that I want to find. You can see that this is 1.5. That's the adjacent and the opposite. Since this is 1, this is all 2, so this is also 1. Let me call this phi equals tan inverse. The opposite, which is 1, divided by the adjacent 1.5. And it is the same thing, 34 degrees. So this is 34 as well. So now I can resolve FJG into two components. The y component here is going to be FJG sine, right? 34. And I will have another force here on the x-axis. And that's going to be FJG cosine 34. This way, I have all the forces FJG and FJC in x and y components. So now I can do my summation force on the x-axis, summation force on the y-axis, and I can resolve them. So let me start with the force on the x-axis. And if I did the summation of forces on the x-axis here, summation forces on the x-axis equals to zero, and I will assume to the right to be positive. So what do I have in the x-axis for this system? FCD going to the left, right? So this is minus FCD. I have minus FJC cosine 34, that's the one in the green, and I have minus FJG cosine 34, that's the magenta color. Do I have anything else? No. So those are the only three. So this should equal to zero. That's your second equation of equilibrium. If you have this constructed, you will get another 0.5. Now, for the y-axis, you need to add as well the reactive forces. So you need to add the one here, which is 20.2. You need to add the 6, right, kilonewtons. and you need to add 9 kilonewtons down here. So that's 9 kilonewtons. So this way you have all your acting and reactive forces, and as well as all the member forces. So don't forget that. So if I want to do this quickly, and the y-axis, I will have a lot of components. So summation of forces in the y-axis equal to 0. Up is positive. I will have minus 6 going down, right? Minus 9. These are the acting forces. Plus 20.2 kilonewtons. That's the support reaction force at E. And then I have minus FJC sine 34 plus FJG sine 34, and that equals to 0. And that's your third equation of equilibrium. Once you have this, you'll add also another 0.5 to your grade, and this will give you 3.5 out of 4 when you reach this point, because you have the equation of the moment, the equation of the x-axis, forces of the x-axis, forces of the y-axis. And if you were able to do the substitution and find at least two of the three variables, which are FCD, FJC, and FJG, you'll get another half a point. And this will add up to 4.4. I want you to do the analysis on your own, because it's substitution. If you do the analysis correctly, your FCD, let me write that here, FCD is going to be 21.3 kilonewtons. And since it's going to be positive, so you are pulling on the joint, right? You're pulling on this joint out, so that's going to be tension. And FJC is going to be, if you do the analysis and substitution, FJC is going to be 8 kilonewtons, and it's going to be negative, actually, as minus 8 kilonewtons. So we have to flip the direction to the joint here, and that's going to be compression, right? So let's put the tension and compression, and the FJG is going to be also negative 18, so that's 18 kilonewtons. And since it's negative, it means it has to go the other direction, pushing on the joint, and that's going to be compression. Remember, finding these values is 0.5 out of 4, but what I care about is finding the equations of equilibrium for the moment, the summation force on the x-axis, summation force on the y-axis. If you have this correctly with the free body diagrams, you will get 3.5 out of 4. And a half a point will be just to do the substitution and find these values. I hope that was helpful. I know it's a long problem, but you know, that's the truss, how we analyze trusses. Thank you for watching. Until the next video. Bye.